Hey, Pazzo, how are you today? Good? All right. In this video now, we'll try to remove the tail. Actually, we're not going to try. We're gonna remove it and then switch it with this one. Supposed to be very tiny and stay here like this instead of having all of this. So if you have nothing to do, grab your favorite drink and stay with us. This is actually not one single part. They have three different components. Unfortunately, they are not really light, but I hope they will give at least a nice view on the tail. But the quality is very good. Metal, nice metal. Very well painted. Yeah, comes with all the necessary instructions, how to remove the parts, how to install it, all the bolts and nuts, even a screw, everything. This is the light for the number plate. And of course now everything need to be removed. All of these plastic parts need to be taken off for the purpose to install the new design. Hey, my friend, how are you? You came here for a close inspection.
Yeah.
Nothing works without you. People will be happy to see you. This is the last time when you're going to see my motorcycle so clean, untouched. After a few months or years, it will be a different story. All the bolts need to be removed and then the tail needs to go backwards, I think. All right. This is what is underneath. This is the famous exhaust holder that is bending if you drop the bike. And when you try to straighten it a few times, it might crack. Unfortunately, you cannot change it. It is welded to the frame. But it is what it is. Just discussed with plumbing future modifications on the filter, the stock filter, but for now I'm gonna keep it at least the next 10 or 15,000 kilometers and then we're gonna see. Maybe we'll switch with K&N or some different options, but for now it will stay as it is. But to change this tail, a lot of parts need to be removed from here. It is not that difficult, but it needs time. Okay, let me check it. Actually, it's not heavy. It's not about the weight, it's about the design this time, not about the weight. The old tail of my old Tenere was very heavy. This one actually is not heavy, but the design is very, very different. So we'll see what we can improve. Light. Yeah, it's like Lego. A lot of parts need to be removed and not back together. Actually, the quality of the plastics is not bad at all. In the kit, there are three metal plates. First one is this, then is this, and then at the end is the actual tail. And only this small bracket needs to be removed from here and installed here on the top for the light. A Loctite is necessary. I don't want to lose the tail somewhere on the bumpy roads. This is support bracket that holds actually the weight, and the second on the top. Go with 4 bolts. Now is the time to mount back the stop light. It has dampers here, so now we need to switch. We'll see if the indicators are gonna match here, because these are the plates for the new tail, but they are just too small compared to the indicators, so we might need to fabricate a different holders. Something very important, the whole procedure is completely reversible, so all the original parts you can keep at home, and if of any case you want to get everything back, you can install it. Also, this bracket, if I'm not mistaken, coming with all necessary documents and all necessary parts, include this part and everything, so you can go easily and make your AMLT. But if you cannot, then you can use the old, mount it again on the bike and go to do it. There is no additional modifications or improvement or something like that. So, as I said, everything is completely reversible. This is the last plate that actually holds this one like this. This is the plate. You can see the angle. This is the light for the registration number plate. Now we need to mount the indicators. One change that I can see now, these are the original indicators, and they're mounted here on the original plastic frame with a specific Yamaha system. They've got this locking mechanism on the other side, but here with the off-the-road bracket comes different holder, this one. And these indicators are not suitable for that. That's why I bought now very simple, cheap indicators to use it. And you see, there are two different points. You can decide where exactly you want to mount it. They will stay on both sides of the number plate. So for now, I'm going to use these indicators. Very, very cheap option. But later, I can change it anytime. Wiring. I'm happy with the build quality. You see, everything is designed well. You see the bolts, they go well. The surface is very smooth, so yeah, design is good. The only unreversible change that we're gonna make is to cut the wiring of the original indicators and connect it here and use it to the system. But it's not that bad, because one of these indicators cost around 20 euros. So if in the near future I need to go back, I can always order it two of these and I'll be fine. So a little change here, like cutting, welding and stuff like that, need to be done, but that's everything. Very important process. Test. Left, right, perfect. Stop light, great. want to tell you something funny. He wears the glasses just because of you. Usually he don't. We cut it a bit because this is designed for a German number plates and they are more this size, like this, but Bulgarian numbers are like this. And if I don't cut it on the both sides, it will stay like this. So yeah. Alright, it is a time to put back everything together and see what is the final result. You see how small is the tail now. Indicators. The light of the registration number plate. This as well. Let me see the light. Yeah. You can see the light here underneath. Now you can see on real the difference. This tail and this tail. I like it. Maybe not everyone will like it, but for me this is much, much better. But anyway, it's a matter of choice. As I said, I like it. Maybe not for everyone, but I'm happy with the result. Thank you very much. Great job as usual. Let's go to right, huh? That was everything from me, guys. I hope that this information will help to at least one person to make the right choice or to make the right modifications. As usual, always ride safe and see you next time. Ciao.